And now, that's late.
Little Miss Rebecca, for my dog. Come on.
You're listening to the PHJD Radio Network, New Orleans.
In this era of changing climate, cities on waterways face increasing risks of inundation. After Hurricane Katrina here in New Orleans, 80% of this city was flooded. So how can better infrastructure and planning protect these cities in a changing future? I've invited Professor Uwe Obrick to come here to New Orleans. Using Professor Obrick's unique expertise in meteorology, we can better understand how to protect communities at risk in an uncertain climate future.
It must have been a nightmare. They did not estimate the risk of a hurricane really hitting this area so precisely. It is combinations of different extreme events which are particularly dangerous.
So you could not just say, oh, there is the wind and there's the flood and there's the rainfall, but really the combination of these things can influence our ability to react to such an event. What I've been doing is natural science, understanding nature better. Knowing the physics, we can try to estimate the possibilities that climate can take and the individual events can take.
Until now, the different scientific fields have been divided. Meteorology on the one side, hydrology, and the risk assessment dealing with damage. To have a service to society, it is necessary to bridge between the different scientific disciplines involved from the natural event to damage. What you produce by combining these different aspects is a better picture of what can happen. Knowing how large an event can be and how large the hazards can be, you can decide what to do. Should you raise the levees? Should you build bigger pumps?
We need to get the right degree of resilience to the infrastructure. So what you can see is an adaptation. And adaptation is certainly what we need to have in the light of climate change. We try to take into account the current climate, but we also try to take into account potential future climates to say we want to be safe for a steadily changing climate. And I think this is a challenge that is motivating me to do my work, which is both interesting in a natural science way, but it is applicable to society and to people. And of course, it is good motivation, helping people directly with the information and indirectly by getting the authorities to have a better approach to the problem.